Hi, this is Chicago Film News. My name is Patrick McDonald of HollywoodChicago.com and the Chicago Film Tour.
And I'm Ian Simmons of Kicking the Seat. And today we're talking about Doc 10, the documentary film festival returning to Chicago, the lovely Davis Theater, between April 5th and 8th. We have a couple of wonderful films to talk about today. The King and RGB. Sorry, it's RBG. I can't get it right. I still can't get it right.
Yeah, baby. This is the third annual Doc 10 Fest, a very successful weekend festival where they show 10 documentaries, pretty simple, at the Davis Theater in Chicago, the Redon Davis Theater.
Yeah, put on by the Chicago Media Project.
Yes. So we were lucky enough to get a couple of previews to see for the Doc 10 Fest, and we're going to start off with The King.
Wait, but that's my line, Pat. Like I said, let's start with The King. Sorry.
So this is a particular interest to me because I am an Elvis Presley fan. I think that Presley is one of those guys who influenced culture so much that that everything wouldn't exist without him, right, in the sense of where we are, where we're at. But they take it to another angle. They take it to an angle about the American dream, which I really enjoyed. And this was one of the best documentaries I would have to have seen in the last 5 years. Now, the impact is I've only seen it very recently.
Right. And very recently.
Very recently. And I don't want to overstate it now, but it really affected me.
Okay. And it's Eugene Jarecki,
yes,
who takes Elvis's Rolls Royce on a cross-country tour of, you know, he hits everywhere. You know,
yeah.
The heartland,
mostly Route 66, the Mother Road, as they call it in America, so.
Yeah, and he talks to, you know, musicians, celebrities,
yes,
talking about the history of Elvis. We talk about the history of racial tensions and war leading all the way up to sort of the Trump era. So it's very comprehensive and very educational and also fun.
It's very much an allegory for what we have experienced since Elvis broke in 1954 to the present day, and as what we experience as a nation. And quite frankly, it's required viewing as far as I'm concerned.
Yeah, I would agree. I thought it was really entertaining, as I said. It's strange because I think some of the people doing the ride-alongs were more compelling than others.
Yes.
You know, some of the celebrity guests, I guess if you can call them that, I would much rather just watch an entire movie. It's like, say, driving cross-country with Ethan Hawke. That's not really a spoiler. It's not a spoiler. But
Hawke was particularly good in it.
Yeah, he
but,
was.
But I also like that they got musicians actually playing in the car.
Yeah.
I mean, I think we're going too in-depth here, but...
No, we're not spoiling anything. We're giving people an idea of what they're in for, but yes, okay, we'll stop there. We'll put the brakes on, as they say. So next, we have RBG.
Yeah.
Yes, and I got it right this time.
All right.
So that is directed by Julie Cohen and Betsy West, and it is the story, the life story of Supreme Court Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg.
Yes.
That's where the RBG comes from.
And what's interesting about this is that The Supreme Court justices are kind of mysterious.
Yes.
A lot of times, you know, they sort of just pop up when they're being nominated and confirmed, but we don't really know much about them. And we if you go up to a person on the street and you say Ruth Bader Ginsburg, they probably say liberal or, you know, or woman or Jewish or whatever they say.
Mm-hmm.
But the point is, there's so much more to her.
It's interesting you use the phrase pop up, because Ruth Bader Ginsburg recently has become a pop icon.
Yes.
In no small part to the notorious RBG, which is sort of a meme based on Biggie Smalls, Kate McKinnon's portrayal of her on Weekend Update on Saturday Night Live. All of this, well, I should say none of this has anything to do with the actual Ruth Bader Ginsburg or RBG, the documentary you're talking about, except that it's kind of mentioned in the film. But this is sort of a beginning of her life through her career up into the social impact that she has today.
And her evolution. The evolution of Ruth Bader Ginsburg is sort of like the evolution of women in America since, let's say, 1950 to present, because she met her husband in 1950.
Yes.
She's 84 years old. And to go through that history from 1950 to almost 2020 is to go through a social revolution.
Yeah, and that's very much what this documentary is interested in. I would say if there's one criticism I have of it, and this is a very minor thing, not to deter anybody from seeing what I think is a very important film, and this kind of gets back to what you were saying about the enigma of Supreme Court people. We learn a lot about Ruth Bader Ginsburg, but we don't really get inside her head, I don't think. And I don't know if anybody really can, because from what we do learn about her in this film, that she is, that her public persona, that seems to be what is going on inside as well.
But I will counter that by saying they do have a lot of her writings, and her briefs read almost like manifestos in a sense. And I think that's where you get in her head. But also I'll say the type of personality she has says that you're not going to get into her head.
So we've talked about a couple of pretty great films premiering at Doc 10 April 5th through 8th at the Davis Theater.
Right.
There's going to be eight more that you can definitely check out.
That's why it's called
Doc 10. Yes.
So we have seen a full 20%
of Doc 10.
And if it's any indication of Doc 10, it's going to be sensational. And one of the hottest documentaries of the year is going to be there about Mr. Rogers.
Yes, Won't You Be My Neighbor?
Yeah.
No, I'm asking you. So for more information and for tickets and showtimes and all that kind of jazz, check out doc10.org.
Very good.
I think that brings us to the conclusion of this segment.
Well,
am I right?
Oh, too, no. I want you guys, if you're going to Doc 10, to feedback a bit. You know, let's hear your opinions about it. Put it in the comments. Put it in the comments section below. And tell us that we are out of our minds. I beg you to.